would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You've got my head spinning, no kidding. I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. 'Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. Oh, how many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind.
Welcome, everybody. Please be seated. On behalf of Brian and Andrew, thank you for joining us this evening as we all go to a new year and new memories. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Mark Stolte, and I'm Brian's godfather. I've watched Brian grow up from a baby to a little girl to a woman who always tried to keep up with her brothers, whether it was playing in the mud or football or any other competitive sport. She was always there. I've always known her to be very trustworthy, and that's an important virtue in a woman today. I got to even see her play in some of her basketball games because she excelled in basketball in high school. One of the things that I found out and I've known about Brian is even when she went to Buff State, all her friends would just talk about how she'd walk into a room and brighten it, how she made it glow, how she made people smile because she was so full of life. That's very important. Andrew, I've only known you for a short time through family get-togethers and weddings. You've been to a few of them because we've had a lot of people getting married. But what I did find out about you is, and I look to my left when I see all these men standing behind you, that you have a lot of friends, and that means something. You are important in their lives, and you're important in their lives, and they're here to support you on this big day. My boys have known you, and they say that you're a great guy. And I know if they say you're a great guy, I know you're a great guy. And more importantly, you play hockey, so you got to be all right. Brian and Andrew came to me and asked me to become an ordained minister, which is a bit of a hoot, but but I was pleased to do it for them. I was very humbled, very honored to be part of this special day. And we're all here to share in this very special moment in their lives. In the time they've been together, they have become more than a couple. They've become each other's half. They've become each other's half, and they've strengthened by their ever-loving, growing love and understanding of each other. They have learned that they can depend on each other, and through each other, they're becoming better people. As they stand before us and unite in marriage, they're declaring to each other to all of us present that they will be each other's side no matter what life brings their way from this day forward. All of us are here today, we have our own love stories. Some are short, others are long. Some are yet to be unwritten, while others are just getting to the good part. There are chapters in all their stories that are sad and disappointing, and others exciting and full of adventure. And that brings us them here. A time to pause, a time to look back, and a time to smile at all the moments that brought them here. And a time to look ahead at all the moments that are still to come. I'm here, we're all here, because we want those moments for you. We're here to hope with you, to support you, to be proud of you, and to remind you that love isn't happily ever after. Love is an experience writing your story. In every moment, big ones like saying, I love you, getting engaged, moving in together, but mostly a million little ones that come in between those big moments. Falling asleep next to each one another, making dinner together. A hug when you get home from work. Don't forget to kiss. And those everyday moments that fuse you together into one big experience of life. This experience is so incredible, words often fail when we try to explain it. By trying to describe love is still one of our favorite pastimes. We use the words to write stories, poems, and songs of love. And love can look different from one person to the next. We all know when it's there, when we see it, and we feel it. I now ask everybody to stand. Bree and Andrew, can you face the crowd? Bree and Andrew, you turn to your guests now to acknowledge the love and to be loved by friends, family, and those who have come here today to support you. To the family and friends of Brian and Andrew, you have a special purpose. You form the community of support that surrounds them each and every day. As cherished family and friends, it is to whom they will come in the coming years, whether in joy or in sorrow. Always stand beside them, never between them. Offer your love and support, not your judgment. Encourage them when encouragement is needed, and listen to them when they ask for advice. In these ways, you can honor this marriage today, for which they will be joined. Do you offer your love, support, and to strengthen their marriage and to bless this family created by their union? Please answer by saying, we do.
We do.
Thank you. You may be seated. Brian and Andrew, you have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. And from the moment of yes to the moment of, from that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you have making commitments in an informal way. All those conversations that were held in the car or at work or over a meal or during long walks, all those conversations that begin with when we are married continue to I will, you will, and we will. All those late night talks that included someday, somehow, and maybe, and all those promises with those unspoken matters of the heart, all those common things and more are the real process of a wedding. Brian and Andrew, the vows that you are about to exchange serve as a verbal representation of the love that you have promised each other. For it is not the words that you speak today which unite you together as one, but the inner sense of love and commitment that each of you feels within your soul. The symbolic vows of what you're about to make are those way of saying to another, you are all the things that we promised and hoped and dreamed. Well, I meant it all in every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another: acquaintance, friend, co-worker, companion, lover, teacher. For you learn from each other, from one another, for the past few years. Surely you will say the words that will take you across the threshold of life, and things between you will never quite be the same. Trust me, there's a leak, I think. I saw that dripping a little bit there. So from today you shall say the word, this is my husband, this is my wife. Do the vows. Will you, Andrew, take Brian to be your wife, your partner in life, and your one true love? Will you cherish your union and love her more each day than you did the day before? Will you trust her, respect her, and laugh with her when she says she didn't really eat the M&Ms and Oreos last night, even though she has colored round dots on her hand? And cry with her, loving her faithfully through good times and bad, regardless of the obstacles you may face together. Will you give your hand, your heart, your love from this day forward, as long as you both shall live? Please answer by saying, I will.
Like, he's thinking about it.
I will.
I was reading this.
Will you, Brian, take Andrew to be your husband, your partner in life, your one true love? Will you cherish your union and love him more each day than you did the day before? Will you trust him, respect him, and laugh with him, even when he wakes up in a bathtub after a night out? Wow. And cry with him like he is right now, loving him faithfully through the good times and through the bad, regardless of the obstacles you may face together. Will you give him your hand, your heart, your love from this day forward for as long as you shall live?
I will.
Better answer faster. Okay, I need the rings.
What rings?
Not the ring on the bathtub, please.
Nope, that one might slide.
Okay. Let me switch this hand here. May these rings be blessed as a symbol of affectionate unity, that the two lives now joined in one unbroken circle. Wherever they go, they always return to one another and to get that togetherness. May these two find each other the love for which all men and women yearn. May they grow in understanding and compassion. May the home which they establish together be such a sanctuary that many will find there a friend. May these rings on their fingers symbolize the touch of the spirit of love in the heart. The wedding ring is a symbol of eternity. It is an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in endless love. And now, as a token of your love and the desire to be forever united in the heart and soul, we now exchange these rings. Andrew, you take Brian's ring and place it on her finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring as a sign of our lifelong commitment.
I give you this ring as a sign of our lifelong commitment.
A sign of our unending love and faithfulness.
A sign of our undying love and faithfulness.
To remind me of the vows I have made this day.
To remind me of the vows I have made this day.
And to pledge to honor you.
To pledge to honor you.
And grow with you.
And grow with you.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
Brian, take Andrew's ring.
I got it.
You got it? Okay, place it on his finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring as a sign of our lifelong commitment.
I give you this ring as a sign of our lifelong commitment.
A sign of unending love and faithfulness.
A sign of
unending love.
Unending love.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
To remind me of the vows that I've made today.
To remind me of the vows I've made today.
And a pledge to honor you.
And a pledge to honor you.
And grow with you.
And grow with you.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives. It's on there.
It's on. I now ask the mothers to come up and light the unity candle. Uh-oh. No, it's not lit.
Yeah, Ryan.
Yeah, Ryan. No, this one.
Thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, you're a heart saver. Let me get out of your way. There you go.
Trick candles.
Trick candle. Can't blow them out. You got no, Maury. No, you just. They're lighting them. Okay, you're good. Thank you. Andrew and Brian, the distinct candle flames represent your lives before this day, individual and unique and special. Please take the candle symbolizing your life before you today and together light the center candle to symbolize the union of your individual lives. As this new flame burns undivided, so will your loves, so shall your lives now be one. For now on your thoughts, we will always be with each other rather than just individual selves. Your plans will be mutual, your joys, your sorrows, both will be shared alike. Although you are now entering into marriage relationship, you do not, however, lose your personal identity. Rather, you use your special individuality to create and strengthen the relationship of marriage. The individual candle represents all of what makes each of you a wonderful, unique person that admires and respects. The unity candle is the center, symbolizes the union of your lives, families, friends, as well as your shining commitment to each other and to a lasting and loving marriage. Please light the candle. You're doing great. Andrew and Brian, we have heard you promise to share your lives in marriage. We recognize and respect the vows that you've made here today before each one of us as a witness. In honesty and sincerity is what you have said and done here today, and by the authority vested in me in the state of New York, I now pronounce you man and wife. Yeah. You have kissed 1,000 times, maybe more, but today the feeling is new. No longer simply partners or best friends, you have become husband and wife. And now you can seal that agreement with a kiss. Today, your kiss is a promise, and Andrew, you may kiss the bride.
Hug.
Yep. Well, I am honored and privileged to announce and to present Mr. and Mrs. Saskowski.